When we left off last time, we finished up the Earth campaign. Well, finished up like the main battles in on Earth. We still have some stuff we can do down here, but it's like just like kind of mop up type missions, I think. Yeah, and I don't really want to do that. Let's go to space. So for space, what do we got going on here? So it's side 7 mission. Luna 2 is it's a patrol. And this is destroy some. Let's destroy some Musi's. Oh, we get. They're giving us a GM to use too.
All hands, battle stations.
Oh, apparently this sounds
launch
like.
Mobile suit.
Okay, well if people are talking, this must have been a like a scripted battle. Not a scripted battle, but like an actual battle that happened in the anime. Yo, what up, RP? How was your Friday? You just tagged me in a tweet. I'll look at it in a second here. Let me finish the mission. Did you tag the stream Twitter account or my regular one? Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. Oh no. Oh, I'm good. Okay, I'll check it. Oh yeah, apparently it is a battle from the anime. You try to share it from your PS4. Oh, you know what? I didn't look at PS5 sales today. I wonder if any became available anywhere. Shit. I mean, not that I would have got one anyway. But they probably would have been purchased by purchasing bots faster than I could have bought one. But it still would have been cool to try again. So we're gonna have these cruisers destroyed before the Gundam even shows up. Ow. Good job, man. Yo, what's up, TZ?
Damage to the ship is increasing.
Hold on 1 second here. If I can get this guy. Dude, every fucking shot he's there we go. Yeah, I'll check it, RP.
It's the rifle. Gundam.
Oh, is Amuro here? Oh, fuck. Okay, so this is like... Okay, this is a scripted fight then. I feel like I read an article or something that said that Walmart was going to have PS5s available at like 3 p.m. today again. Like they were doing those sales before online. That I tried like 2 weeks ago, I think it was. And I didn't get any of that either, so I would probably not have gotten them today either, anyways. I can't see anybody getting them at this point, like for Christmas. So I also read an article that said that they had, like apparently one of like the scalpers bought like 3,000 PS5s and was reselling all of them for like, I think it was like over $1,500 a piece or something like that. Which, you know, that's what it is. Ed from work got his kid one. Did he order it online? What the fuck? How does that even work out that way? I don't understand that. They're all like mid-space missions too. Like that's not fun. He did. Dude, he must have got like super lucky then. I literally was like ordering, like pressing like purchase the minute, like to the second, as soon as the clock would strike like 3 or 6 or 9. To try to get one. I didn't get it. I tried like 4 or 5 times and it didn't work any of those times. So I don't know. And I love to be in the woods got one. Yeah, I don't fucking get it, dude. I don't understand how he did that. The luckiest motherfucker in the world, apparently. Okay, it's just a normal mission, I think. So we're just gonna take... Let's just take a GM out. A gym, as they call it. And then throw in the gun tank with us. A regular gun tank. Alright, there's nobody here. This thing has 500 health. God damn. I mean, it's a 4-star, so... Kind of makes sense. I don't like the way the beam rifle sounds though on it. No, I dodged that. Come on, game. Alright, well, apparently he got priority there still. Alright, well, the gun tank got that kill by itself. Maybe I should play as the gun tank. All right, well, the fight's over. Gun tank got him. Easy. But yeah, I mean, I'll assume that I'll probably be able to get a PS5 like sometime next year, hopefully. Cause I do want to play Demon's Souls on it, but like by then they'll have more games, I guess, too. We'll see.
I'm sending a space support unit. It's not exactly a mobile suit.
Oh, it's a fucking ball.
We intend to use these to defeat the Zeon forces. Use it wisely.
Thanks, dude. I've always wanted a ball. Acquired missile pod for the Zeon Zaku. Alright, that's cool. Oh, while I'm thinking about it, shouts to TZ for your crazy comrade shirt. Thank you, dude. You can kind of see it. Right there. There it is. It's not like they'll stop making them or anything. So like what they're doing right now with this like commodity thing is like they're driving up the demand for them and just not making enough to sell. I guess it could be because of COVID. They're saying because of the pandemic they aren't like selling. They are like the factories aren't making enough of them. But like I don't remember PS3 or PS4 being that hard to buy on release. Same with Xbox 360 and Xbox One. Because I'm pretty sure I got an Xbox One like as soon as it released. I could be wrong though. I had it for that first Christmas after it came out. I didn't like buy it day one or anything, but like they were like purchasable in store like around Christmas still. So I don't know. It'd be interesting to see like the amount of people trying to buy them that are left. Like whenever they go on, like are they like is there actually like a problem right now where we can't get enough of them in to sell to everybody, or are they available but the scalper, like the purchasing bots, are buying them too fast? We'll take a level 4 ball with us. I'm never gonna use that unless I have to. Cause like, if there's like a lot, like a large percentage of people who still have not been able to acquire a PS5 or that want one, and they're still selling out instantly like that, and no one's getting them, like, there's obviously a problem going on, you know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, but it's like, that's like an unsavory business practice though, RP, if they're, artificially increasing demand for a product, you know what I mean? It's like what Nintendo does with all the stuff they release, if I'm being honest. Cause like, you know how like whenever the, what are they called? They're like the figurines you can use with like the Nintendo stuff. Like you like put them on like your Switch and they like load something in. I forget what they're called. They look like little action figures. Amiibos, yeah. So like with the Amiibo releases, Nintendo only makes so many of each one. That way they become extremely expensive to get them. And that's been like confirmed by like different sources also. They're doing that on purpose. Which, you know, that's just trash. That's why you can find like a million Mario amiibos, but like not like certain Fire Emblem characters and like certain Zelda characters. Just, it's not cool. I don't like it. It's called making money, bitch. I mean, yeah, but like at the same time, why wouldn't you want your products to be accessible to people? Also, we're like the best new type ever right now. We got a rank A. Do I want to do that one? What's happening on Texas Colony? Let's go there. That sounds better. We can take a ground gun amount. Oh, we have a... Dude, do we take a... Let's bring Thick Boy with us. Because if you can make more money on things, the people are going to buy regardless, why wouldn't you? No, I mean, like, I understand. Like, from a strictly profit standpoint, yeah, why wouldn't they do that? It just kind of, like, is bad for the... It's anti-consumer, is what I'm saying. And as a business, you wouldn't want to be anti-consumer. But like you're saying, Nintendo knows they're going to make sales regardless. Yeah, I mean, it's just shitty. But I mean, like, generally speaking, Nintendo's a relatively anti-consumer company anyway. Because even when it comes to, like, streaming and whatnot, for the longest time, a lot of creators had a hard time playing Nintendo games because they would get copyright flagged. Like, constantly. Like, I think you'd be a part of a, like, a program now with Nintendo to stream their newer titles and not worry about them getting taken down or demonetized. Now, I've heard that was a thing. Not ever really played Nintendo games on stream to worry about that. At least newer ones. We played, did I play any old Nintendo games? I guess technically, Final Fantasy IV was a Nintendo game at one point. You know what I mean? Even though we covered the PSP version of it. So I guess that wouldn't count anyway. But I think all the games we played thus far, ever, on the channel, I don't think any of them were Nintendo games. Now, my main concern would be I'd like to play Fire Emblem on stream at some point, and it is obviously a Nintendo game. We'd probably play the GBA ones, though. So, I mean, I would hope we wouldn't have a hard time covering that, because that would kind of suck. Because that's an actual, like, Nintendo-owned franchise, where even, like, with the Final Fantasy ones, there's still a Square Enix game that is, like, playable on Nintendo, which I think falls under a different category than, like, Mario or Zelda. Dude, they're gonna sit up there and just fuck me up, huh? That's what's gonna happen here? Dude, are you fucking kidding me? They might ding for the music. So yeah, I mean, that would be the one concern, right? So, I mean, we'll see what happens whenever we get there. Because a lot of... whenever I was putting the Final Fantasy IV Let's Play on YouTube, the music got called a lot for copyright. But it was, like, not even our region. It was different regions that were copyright claiming it, not NA. So I'm not entirely sure how all that works either. I'm probably going to lose this mission, for the record. If I get shot one more time, I'm dead. Like, I think if we get friendly fire, we're going to die, even. And I'm out of ammo, so I can't even get close to him. I'm just going to stand here. Maybe I'll be okay. The Zoc's getting fucked up, though. Oh, I got hit. What the fuck? Oh, all right. That's our first loss, I think, on this campaign. I didn't even see the missile come at me. That's okay, though. Oh, the mission's still available. Let's just do it. What should we take, being that our ground Gundam got fucked? Oh, we have two Gundams now. That's cool. No, we don't. I'm crazy. We still have one. All right, let's try again with a slightly less good Gundam. And let's take this guy with us. We should be fine. It's a normal mission, but apparently... not going fine. All right, get away from me. I see you back there. So yeah, I was thinking that this will probably be our last stream of Federation versus Zeon. Because I think we're going to finish the campaign tonight. Because we should only have... We have the Solomon scenario and then Jaburo, and that's it. So, and I think we're doing, like, the intro stuff before that right now, so... What am I going to stream tomorrow? I would like to play Tales. I want to finish Tales tomorrow. Like, finish it. Like, all the side, whatever side stuff I'm going to do, and, the story. Because I think, I really want to just do the Code Red Demon hunts, and then, which there's only, like, 3 or 4 left, and then do the last few boss fights. I can put the command in for you, yes. So you can ruin the... We had a beautiful Tales of Berseria playthrough, and I'll put the command in for the last stream so you ruin it. Because I have a feeling you're going to make me play as Lofi set, and it's going to go very, very poorly for me against the last boss. The last couple bosses. But yeah, I'll put it in. I can do it after stream, actually. Actually, RP, are you going to be up a little bit later tonight? Because if you are, can you just, like, send me a text when I'm done with stream to say, hey, add the command? Dude, this is, like, way too hard for a normal mission with this guy right here. Jeez. Because I don't know if I can actually add a command live or not. I probably could add a command live. I can try after this, actually. Hold on. I will. RP, what do you want to name the command? No, I'm just gonna add the command. You don't have to spend your points tonight. I don't even know what kind of modifier we would use for this game anyway. Jeez. Thank God we won. That mission took way more effort than it needed to. Alright, let me see here. Okay, what can I do from this screen? Stream info, rage, no prime. Okay, so let's see if I do this. Go to Twitch. How do I add commands? The creator dashboard? I might have to look at this after stream. Yeah, I'm gonna look after it after stream. Because I don't remember what it's called now. Like, the actual, where you gotta add them at. I think you have to do it through the creator dashboard or something like that. I don't know. I'll look at it after stream and do it. Oh, wait a second. Hold on a second. I think I see it. Channel analytics. Channel points. Manage rewards and challenges. Custom rewards. Default rewards. Add new custom rewards. Give your reward a name. Modify the game on stream. Description. The command. All right, how much you want the cost? Where am I? 100k? Oh, I can put an icon. I'll do it after stream, add the icon. Because I just want to make it the emote anyway. Let's do that. Great. I want creator dashboard. All right, RP, see if it's there now. I guess I can do that too. Yeah, modify the game on stream. Yeah, okay. Hey, RP, go ahead and redeem that real quick to see if it works. You said wow. Can you please confirm that? Can you please do that for me? What is this? Destroy the bra bro? I don't know if I want to fight that. I think you killed a bot right there. Yojimbo attacked a bot. Alright, so maybe... Alright, we can do this fight. Hold on, let me just... I'll take the gun cannon, and we'll take... a Rikdom with us. This is probably not good for the Rikdom's health, but we'll see what happens. I'm actually not sure if the gun cannon was the right move, because this thing might be a little mobile. Oh no, it's this guy. I was thinking of the Bigro, not the Bra-Bro. Oh yeah, we're gonna be alright. Maybe. Hopefully. I don't know, actually. Should have took something with beams, I think. God, they move so slow. Ow. The last person I fought in Tales of Berseria was Shigure, correct. So we have at least three boss fights left, I think, for the main story. Unless there's a twist at the end, then probably more. Yo, is my Rikdom buddy getting fucked up right now? I feel like he is. Oh, got him. Ow. Oh, no. Dude, what the fuck even hit the Rikdom, did I think? Dead. Alright, that wasn't too bad. The gun cannon didn't get fucked up too much right there. So RP, if you want to see exactly how far I am, if you look up Fighting Cowboys Let's Play of Tales of Berseria, I believe the boss names were stream title or were episode names. So you can see how many episodes he has left after the Shigure fight, and that's about how long I have left in the game, probably. I think it's about like 2 hours of like main stuff. So that's like boss fights and story, like cutscenes and stuff. So we're also gonna go do hunt down some Code Red demons though. So that's gonna take some time. Not a lot, but it's still gonna take time. Alright, we're going in to destroy Zanzibar, it looks like. The fun thing is that we don't have anything good at destroying that Zanzibar. I could take a gun tank in space, but that sounds like suicide, being that it's a tread-based unit. And it's slow as fuck. What do we bring with us? 2-star GM? Why not? The old gym. What's the worst that could happen? Really, you can't one-shot a Zaku 2? At point-blank range, okay. Just don't look at me. Ow. I'm pretty sure this never happens in the anime. Like, I don't think they ever have the gun tank flying around in space like this. Dude, stop shooting at me. I'm trying to destroy your ship. Leave me alone. Oh god, he's like, oh my ass. Where the fuck is my ally? Please hit the mobile suits for me. Alright, we got him. Right in the ass. Jeez, that Rick Dom got a little aggressive at the end there. All good, though. Why does this look like it's tilted up? Was it? I don't even know if it moved right there. All right. Okay, we have commenced an offensive attack against Solomon. General Rebel made a speech to all our forces.
The first step of this great battle depends on your courageous actions. When our Federation forces have won this battle,
he prays for our success. Oh no, all the Earth. Oh, okay. Well, it's all space now. All right. So, enemy battle strength 0. We get a three star gem for free. That's good. Oh, we get a launch thing too. So the reason they're launching off the ship like that as opposed to out of it, I think it's because those Federation ships were designed before we had mobile suits. Also, that's a Bawaku, I think, right there. No, that's Solomon, never mind. But yeah, the ships were designed before mobile suits were a thing, and they didn't have any mobile suit bearing ships besides the white base, on the Federation side at least. The Zeon ships could hold mobile suits in them. Dude, come on. Well, it's kind of my fault right there, but yeah. Blame the unit. Oh, missed. No. Okay. He threw a grenade at me. Asshole. I do like how they actually pulled the beam saber off their back for the GM, and the Gundam does it too. Like most of the units, the Dom is an exception over there also with the heat saber or heat sword or whatever it is. But like a Zaku too, you can actually see the heat hawk on it, which I actually did not know this. I brought it up before. The Zakus carry heat hawks. They're called heat hawks because they're supposed to be heat tomahawks, and heat hawk is just the abbreviation of it. I never knew that. It's kind of really straightforward once you hear it, but that is, I didn't know that. Oh, there's the Bigro. That's who I thought we were fighting earlier, but it was the Bra-Bro, not the Bigro. It's probably a waste of time trying to fight this thing. Oh, maybe not. I need you to attack me, though. No? Alright. Yeah, the mobile armors kind of can move any direction really quickly in space, whereas we can't really. That's why you see it make those sporadic turns and whatnot like that. Like, the really sharp turns. Can't line it up. Oh, I think that was a little too early. Got him. All right, that wasn't too bad. We did it in one life, too. We did lose 3 allies, though. Damn, another space mission.
I'm sending you a mobile suit. It's a V Project prototype, but I hear that its performance is acceptable. Use it wisely.
Hopefully it's a gun cannon? It is a gun cannon. Okay, cool. All right, defend allied battleship. Oh, this is going to be not a fun mission. This is not going to be fun. Is it a hard mission? It is. Fuck. Okay, so we could use... We could use the Gundam for this and save the gun cannon for the Big Zam fight, which RP Big Zam will be here again tonight. We'll be fighting him instead of helping him. I'm gonna take the Gundam. Yeah. And then bring... Shit, what do we bring with us to defend this ship? I don't want to take my 3-star because we're gonna need that. I guess we'll just take a gun tank with us, which is not a good idea in space, but... It'll be fine, right? The Federation's White Devil! Oh, get one shot. So technically, those Zaku 2 machine gun rounds shouldn't hurt the Gundam, even though they do in the game, for gameplay mechanics. Can't one-shot a Rikdon. That makes sense, I guess, though. Oh, no. Oh, come on. No, don't hurt me. Yeah, that combo right there. Wait, what did I just do there? How do I do that? Hold on a second. I gotta see that again. What the fuck was that? A long-ass defense mission. You're telling me he got priority right there? I don't agree. No. Unnecessary damage. I do need this Gundam fixed before, like, too long, because we're going to need it for some of the end missions. I think we might get another one, though, like a 1-star Gundam, instead of just a base model. Yeah, that little kick combo right there. How do I do that? I don't know what, like, procs that. Maybe if I hit the start of the combo when I hit the trigger? I don't know. Ow. No. Oh, come on, dude. The gun tank just dropped a round into my head. So, we'll see how long it takes to finish up Federation versus Zeon. If it's, like... not too far into stream when we finish up. I'll probably hop over and play some WoW again tonight. I did get max level today, so I'm gonna do some of the endgame stuff. Oh, this Magellan's getting a little weird. Or not a little weird, a little weak. Well, there goes my accuracy rating. So, being that we're going to finish up Tales of Berseria this weekend, on Tuesday of next week, we're going to end up doing Final Fantasy X. And one of the big decisions I have to make before we get there is if I'm going to use the standard sphere grid or the expert version. So if you didn't know, the sphere grid's how you level up your characters in Final Fantasy X. And I guess RP is partial to the expert version. I've never actually played through the game on with the expert sphere grid. I've only played with the standard, like, base game one. No makeup pit people, I guess. Well, I mean, we'll see whenever I finish up with Tales of Berseria tomorrow. And if it's early, I don't know what you're doing tomorrow. We can maybe do something in the evening or at some point, RP. You've beaten the game like 5 times using the regular sphere grid. That is correct. Yeah, I probably about 5 times with the regular sphere grid. Never with the expert though. So I'm probably gonna play Tails in the middle of the day, RP. So what I was worried about using the expert sphere grid was that I would like all the characters wouldn't really be classes anymore, so I would only use like 3 characters in the entire time. You know what I'm saying? Like I like to use the full party at least for part of the game. I guess I don't know anything about the expert sphere grid to know how that actually plays differently than the regular one, besides that it's laid out differently. So, RP, is it like, could you easily explain what the difference between the regular sphere grid and expert sphere grid is? Like, what I'm looking at in terms of the differences there? Like, is it reorganized differently? Or are the skills still in the same spots? You're gonna check your notes? Okay. Because if it's still the same layout, but just like you go about it differently, I'm fine with that. But I still would like the characters to kind of fall into classes for a little while at least. I know like towards the end we'll probably focus in on like 3 characters to play as the most. At least that's what I've done in the past. But like for the beginning part, I would like to be able to play around with everybody. Especially when you're fighting the different like flying enemies, defensive enemies, that kind of stuff, switching in and out characters. Dude, that Zaku just tripped me. Leg sweep right there. Oh, and I'm surrounded now. Let's get over here. Ow. Okay. Okay, guys. Hold on a second. Calm down. It's okay. Stop shooting me. God fucking damn it. He didn't die. Oh, there he is. Oh, dodge. Oh, that was close. We are in a little kind of... We're dangerous territory right now. This is uncomfortable. We got here. Zaku 2. Okay. Good. Alright, get up. They are not taking a lot off that meter when they die. Which makes sense, they're only Zaku 2s. That Rigdon might be able to one-shot me now. I'd be careful. Come on. Alright, I'm gonna go down here. I feel safer down here with the Zaku. And before the Zaku kills me. Oh, come on. You couldn't give me a Vulcan kill for once, game? Dude, he's like one shot. Come on. Get him, somebody. Ally. Oh, my bad, dude. Alright, we won. Whew. That was way too close for comfort there. Alright. Give me a... Yeah. Good. Rescue allied units. Okay, this is not going to be a big Zam mission yet, thankfully. Let's take our regular gun cannon. I'm saving the +1 gun cannon, or 1-star, whatever they're called. Tier 1, I guess. Gun cannon for the big Zam mission. The expert sphere grid is smaller, apparently. Alright, what does that mean to me? Does that mean you can get people, like, all the same abilities still? How's it smaller, then? Would that mean that you don't get to, like, level everybody up as far? Like, are there not as many, like, stat boosts, I guess? Oh, you get stronger slightly faster. Okay. I guess I'm wondering what the allure of using the expert sphere grid actually is, then. Because it sounds like it would be easier to use it if you get stronger faster, but is it, like... I don't know. I guess maybe... Well, what it probably is if you already know how the game works and what the skills are and everything and what you want to build your characters like, it probably gives you more leeway with that, I have to assume. Because if that's not what it is, then I have no idea what it does. He dodged every single one of those shots. Ace pilot, right there. And now he's gonna kill that ball. Nope, got him. All right, so there aren't as many dedicated stat nodes, so you can customize a little more, and everyone kind of starts in the middle of the grid. So I can go any path pretty easily. Interesting. I mean, that doesn't sound horrible. I'm just trying to think if it would, like, how different the experience would be using that as opposed to the standard, you know what I mean? Because I really think the regular base experience of Final Fantasy X is amazing. I don't want to ruin that by using a different sphere grid. They still have obvious paths for each character. So is it really cutting out a lot of the nodes that you can customize to whatever you want with, like, the spheres? Is that what's actually happening here? Because that's probably how they made it smaller then. Which, I mean, if I'm being completely honest with you guys, I don't really use the spheres that much anyway besides unlocking the blocked paths. Because I'm not, like, we're not, like, going for, like, a penance killer or anything like that. Or all the Dark Aeons. We're kind of just playing to enjoy the game, you know what I mean? Basically how I play every game on the channel, just to enjoy it, not to necessarily 100% it or anything. That's just not really my thing. Get up, bitch. Alright, well, I think you're convincing me to try it, RP. It would at least, it would make a difference for me, though. So that could actually be kind of fun. Have you played all the way through using the Expert Sphere Grid RP? I know you've beaten Final Fantasy X a good bit. Also, you have to customize your grids in both to get max stats. Yeah, so, like, I'm not super worried about, you know, getting max stats on characters or anything like that. Because even, like, when we played it on stream last time, I think it was only, like, a 50-hour playthrough or something like that, and, like, we blew through the end of the game. Like, we were power leveled enough, like, by not even power leveling, just, like, doing some side stuff, to where the last boss was, like, inconsequential. Unlike, like, for example, Final Fantasy XIII's Let's Play way back in the day where I barely beat the last boss and had to figure out a mechanic that, like, you know, the poison strat for him, or I wouldn't have won. I mean, I'm probably not going to play the Dark Aeons. At least not all of them. Because you can just use the Zanmato cheese with your Jimbo and kill all of them in one shot. And the only part that gets annoying about that is you have to grind for money. I mean, what am I missing? I'm missing, like, boss fights. That's it. Like, they're just boss fights that you do in X2 anyway. Right. Yeah, so I mean, what you do is you just save scum the Yojimbo alt or Zanmato attack until you get it, and then you kill the Dark Aeon on one hit, which is like, I don't find that very fun, you know? Because can you fight the Dark Aeons legitly? Like, I feel like they one-shot you, like, pretty consistently and pretty easily. Especially when you go to, like, Bahamut and the Maga Sisters and stuff. You can fight them. So, without having your characters at triple or quadruple nine stats. Alright, let's protect the solar system weapon that, like, burns the whole face of the planet off whenever they fire it. Oh, but the question is, what do I use? Because all my space shit's fucked up. I mean, it's only a two, it's a normal mission. We can probably just do this. You have to grind for good stats. Your stats can only go up to 255. I mean, okay. I'm thinking of health bars, I guess, is what I'm saying. Quadruple nines. I don't know. I could probably try to do a couple of the Dark Aeons. Like, we did Dark Valpor last time, just for the hell of it. What I would like to try to do, though, on this Let's Play is get as many of the legendary weapons as possible. So I think last time I only got I got Titus, Orin, and Yuna, because that was the party we ran with. But I'd also like to try to get Kamari's and Waka's. The problem with Waka's, obviously, is the RNG with the Blitzball tournaments. And the problem with Lulu's is the dodging 200 lightning strikes, so... I had an idea for the lightning strike minigame to try, but like, it's not gonna be fun, so we're not gonna actually do it. If you did like, take a drink every time you got hit by lightning, like, I feel like that could be a really fun concept, but I feel like I would just black out and it wouldn't be fun then. Because if you think about it, the more you drink, the worse you're gonna be at the minigame. Being that it's all timing. But I don't think we're gonna do that. I'd probably die. Yeah, I probably would die. Yeah. It would. Well, what would happen is there'd probably be one attempt where we got like to 100 dodges or something like that. Then I would get hit and I would not try again because it'd be miserable. Like, I don't understand who actually does that minigame and completes it. Like, what kind of person that takes. The mental fortitude to do that is just crazy. That might be the hardest. Well, I say hardest minigame. It's not like difficult. It's just like, it's like just outrageous what you have to do. So I think we're actually gonna have to fight one Dark Aeon at least, because we have to go back to Besaide for something. I went back to Besaide in the last playthrough for some reason, and we had to fight Dark Balfour. I forget why I went back. I think it was for a Jet Sphere, I want to say. So we're going to have to do at least one Dark Aeon fight again. The only boss he used Zanmato on was Dark Anima because of the length of the boss fight. Yeah, it was for the Overdrive RP. So I think there might be a way to go back earlier and get it, and I just like missed that window. So we had to fight him. Because I think whenever you get access to the airship the first time, you're able to go back to Besaide if you want to. And the Dark Aeon wouldn't be there yet, you know what I mean? But I don't remember. Yeah, I think I just missed the original window to grab it, and I was going back to get it, and that is why I had to fight him. Because I think we got the Zanmato proc on like the first or second try. It was like really fast. Yeah, well, we can worry about that when we get there. That's still far. That's a ways into the playthrough, even. Boom, there we go. Complete. Alright, using our new solar system weapon against Solomon, we have succeeded in dealing a crushing blow to the enemy.
I am sending a mobile suit to you now. Our technicians say it is superior to the Zeon Zaku, but unfortunately, we don't have many to spare.
Okay.
Use it well.
Oh, is it another high-level GM? It's a ground Gundam? What the fuck am I gonna do with a ground Gundam in space? Alright. Okay, RP, here's the moment of truth. Here's the big boy for you. There he is.
I'm launching now. Take over.
How do you even know what the Big Zam is, RP? Like, why do you know about him? Like, generally speaking. Because you mentioned the Big Zam, like, a long time ago for some reason. I don't know why. What are you saying? Big Zam the science guy. You can leave a clip. Is it an appropriate clip? Is there any copyrighted music in the clip or anything like that? If it's appropriate and there is no copyrighted music, then you can link it, and I'll watch it.
Go down. Go down. Hey, pal, watch who you shoot. That thing's not gonna hurt anyone else. Hey, Gundam, take care of him for me.
So, at some point, we'll cover MS Saga and New Dawn, and the representation of the Big Zam in that game is much better, for, like, in terms of craziness, because he's like, a legit boss fight, as opposed to just an enemy flying in front of us. So, it, like, does it more justice than it is right now. I think there, and also in, like, Mobile Suit Gundam Encounters in Space, which is another really good Mobile Suit Gundam game, the Big Zam's portrayal is much better than in this game. But then again, in this game, it was not meant to be anything too crazy. And Dozel actually says that line right before he dies, and he's not about to die yet. The 3 minute long, is it, so did you check for the, is there any kind of copyright stuff in it, RP? Because I'll pull it up on stream, if it's okay. Like, if it's a clean video. If not, I'll just watch it later. Okay.
How can a single mobile suit...
Goodbye. Just two best friends talking. Okay. All right. I guess the other question I should ask you is, what's the cringe level of this video? All right. So we've successfully defeated Zeon at Solomon already. Okay. Let me see if I can do this now. All right. So how can we watch this video? If I create a new scene. How do I do this? Let me think. What do we got on here? We got break. Oh wait, we can do league. Wait, or no? LOL. Wait, that's just the screen, I think. Yeah, this will work. Okay.
This is Gundam.
Yeah.
Battle Assault.
D-U-M.
Look at the side of the box. Gundam.
Gonna be Big Zam.
You're gonna be Big Zam?
Big Zam, motherfucker!
What the fuck?
You better recognize.
Well, if you're gonna be Big Zam, then I'm gonna be Ball.
Well, good.
I can't believe you're Big Zam on the first fight.
Why not?
Have you ever played this?
Nope.
All right. You'll be...
Have I made a horrible mistake?
More like...
Oh, is this Game Grumps? I think I've seen this before.
That's how I do it.
Just Big Zam.
Who should I be now?
I don't know.
I think I'll be Big Zam.
That's what I thought.
I'm gonna be fucking New Zizel.
Good.
He's bigger than Big Zam.
Yeah, wow. Can I get a few more fucking vowels in that name?
I think that the Big Zam would beat the the Gato character on the right, because it had all beam weapons. Did they actually fight?
Yeah, no, I wouldn't do that.
I gotta be Psycho.
Hey, Big Zam. Sweet. Let's do this.
I've destroyed you twice.
Yeah. It might be because I'm terrible at this game.
It might be because we're fighting with boss characters.
Oh, is that what's going yeah. on? I'm not too familiar with the Gundam world.
The whole top row is boss.
This
characters.
Game actually is really fun. This is a Gundam Battle so, Assault 2.
So these are all like normal characters.
Right.
Here.
So if I were to pick,
I believe it's a PS1 game.
I don't know, like Big Zam, for instance.
All right, I'm gonna burn you up with burning Gundam.
Fine.
Anything like that.
Let's do it.
I'm gonna use my burning finger.
Cool.
All right. So all right. I think I'm gonna have to go.
Oh, I like Psy.
Does he keep picking Big Zam over and over again?
Psy?
Yeah.
I have no fucking clue, dude. I don't watch Gundam.
Is that what's happening here?
Peru 2. Are there two Perus?
He's a clone.
There he is. Moro.
Akahana looks pretty cool. Hey, Big Zam.
He picks Big Zam every time. Yeah, that's what I thought.
What a choice.
Oh, this is awesome.
Ah, you've done it.
Super, great.
This is bullshit.
Oh, man. That's unfortunate.
All right. That's funny. Okay, so I understand what you're talking about now, where you're coming from. I was wondering why you knew what it was, because it's like kind of like a random thing to know about Mobile Suit Gundam, just Big Zam. That's the bit, picking Big Zam over and over again. Okay, mop-up battle. Let's just go. I think you may have shared that with me before, because that seems like oddly familiar for some reason. Yeah, I think you did, because I think I asked you about it like a while ago for some reason. That we were talking about it or something. Because the Big Zam wasn't in any of the other Gundam games I've played so far. I think it's because way back when I said, hey, I'm going to start playing Gundam games occasionally on stream, you said something about Big Zam, and that's how it came up. And then you probably shared the video in Discord or something. Do I like salt and vinegar chips? Absolutely not. I hate them. I feel like there are two kinds of people when it comes to salt and vinegar chips. Either you love them or hate them. I can't stand them. You see salt and vinegar Pringles? I don't want that. No. No, thank you. The bets. My favorite Pringles, though, are the pizza Pringles. I'm sure you've had those before, right? Oh, we missed. Damn it. Come on. No? They're the best? Dude, I agree. Pizza Pringles are the best. Fuck. Okay, dude. Chill. What? Hey, calm down. You guys lost this fight already. Leave me alone. Listen, I was in your shoes before. Literally like a week ago when we were playing a Zeon. I understand what it feels like. Growing up, you loved sour cream and onion chips, but your palate has matured now. I think sour cream and onion is still good. So if I was like, let's say for example, I was drunk and I was at a gas station and I was going to buy some chips to eat. Okay. I would grab Ripples original. That's it. I love them. I used to, so when in college, there was a quick fill across the street from where me and Dalton lived. And we would go out and we'd come home. We'd stop at the gas station, grab like a Lunchable, and I'd grab a bag of chips, Ripples original chips. Amazing. The greatest drunk snack ever. And I'm not proud to say that I usually ate the whole bag that night. But it was good. It wasn't like a little bag of chips, like a single serving. It was like the one you'd buy like at a grocery store. Okay, RP, what's your favorite kind of Lunchable? Or anybody, what is your favorite kind of Lunchable? Because I have a hot take when it comes to Lunchable variety on what I like. I didn't think it was, but apparently it is. See, okay. So RP, your favorite is the pizza Lunchable. Mine I like the ones you can make little sandwiches out of. That's my favorite. Any kind. What is it, like the common one? Is it bologna? It's not bologna, is it? I think it is. But dude, that's the one I always go for. The little sandwiches with like the little cookie in it. You know what I'm talking about? That's what I always go for. Never the pizza. Not the nachos. And nope, just ham and cheese. Yep. Ham and cheese. Good. That's good. Always, it has to be a sandwich Lunchable or I don't go for it. Now, if I had to eat a pizza Lunchable, would I? Yes, obviously. But it's just not traditionally what I go for when it comes to Lunchables. It's a normal Solomon space mission. We can't die. All of our shit's fucked up, though. Home in 60? Alright, Dalton. So, Dalton, if you're here still, well, I say this very quickly. After I finish this game, like, actually finish the campaign, I was gonna hop on WoW if you guys wanted to do something. And I was gonna say something else. What was it? Oh, Dalton, I was just talking about when we lived across from Quickfill and my Lunchable preferences versus most of the world's, apparently. RP also is a fan of the pizza Lunchable, but I like the sandwich kind. This is probably not a good idea, by the way, taking the Zaku 2 for this mission. We're probably gonna get fucked up. I should have took the bazooka also. So I made two mistakes here. And I'm gonna pay for them, I feel like. As I was saying, I think we're gonna pay for it here. We'll see. RP, I don't know if you'd like World of Warcraft to actually play it. Like, you like Final Fantasy, but you like Final Fantasy in general. I don't know if you'd like WoW very much. Say it again, you lost connection. Seriously, Dalton? That's okay. I was telling, me and RP were talking about, Lunchables. And I was telling him about how we used to live across from Quickfill, and how you always went for the pizza Lunchables, and I would always go for the sandwich ones. And RP said his favorite Lunchable was the pizza one, and mine is the sandwich one. And most people don't share that opinion. Like, most people are pizza Lunchable people. I'm not. Why do you struggle with 14, RP? You're not even, like, in the hard part of 14 yet. If you would catch up, we could do that as a co-op stream, also. Did you hear what I said that time, Dalton? Or should I hold my comment till you have better service? Oh, you heard that time, okay. RP is a man of culture. Apparently I'm not, yeah. I never understood the want for the pizza Lunchable as opposed to the little sandwiches. Also, you get the cookies. Who doesn't want the cookies inside of the sandwich Lunchable? Like, why would you not want that? A little sweet at the end of the night? Well, at the end of your meal, I guess. If you're eating them in a regular setting and not a drunk setting. I mean, I suppose we can just have differing opinions on it. That's fine. I'm going to die now. The problem is, if RP would play WoW now, if he'd have to make a new character, because I wouldn't want him to boost the character and then try to figure out what's going on. Dude, is he dead yet? Oh, come on. I think if he dies, we win. I'm out of ammo. I have no allies. Fuck, we're gonna die. God damn it. Oh, it's so close. Yeah, that was a bad situation. The Zaku 2 was not the move there. If it was, we should have took the bazooka. That would have worked out better. Alright, well, we have to finish this mission, apparently, so... I'm taking a gun cannon, and then we'll take... I think the ball died. He did die. No, he didn't. He must have died. Take the Rikdom as backup. I'm not, admittedly, not good in these, like, free-floating space areas. Have him do Exile's Reach, then go to Legion. I mean, RP, if you wanna... We can guide you. You know, if you wanna... Test the waters, as they say. It sucks he doesn't get a free month. Ooh, actually, if I refer him, Dalton, will he get a free month of WoW or anything like that? Or can you do that or somebody, like, to get him a, some, like, a free month to try it out? And make him a Blood Elf since he's big on anime? Oh, RP loves the pretty pixels. We've discovered this. We've played enough co-op games with character creators to know that RP is all about pretty pixels. So, anything... We'll make him a female Blood Elf and we'll be right at home. Come here. No. You're gonna watch the stream while you drive, just don't wreck. You got nothing going on in a cabinet full of G Fuel? Dude, RP, we staying up all night? Is that what's happening here? So, yeah, Dalton, did you hear what I said? Is there a way to get RP a free month so you can try it out? That basically said the Space Fortress Solomon has fallen. We won that victory there, so that's good for the Federation.
I am sending a mobile suit to you now. It is a new model made in Jaburo.
I think it's a GM. A gym.
Use it well.
Oh, most certainly is.
Everything's going well. I'm dispatching the supply core to you.
Okay.
The new type core? Propaganda. Designed to mask how exhausted they've become. New types are supposedly people who can live without war. They are not psychics.
So, I don't... That's not necessarily true. We captured a Rickdom also. Okay. There is a way to get him a free month? Cool. Okay, good. I stayed up till 3 a.m. playing with Digimon last night. I can do it again for a while, I guess. I mean, maybe not 3 a.m. if you don't stay up that late if you don't want to, but... Wait, what's this very hard mission? Hold on, let's look at this real quick. Enemy battle strength is 0. Oh, we're helping out Amuro here. Okay, I can do that. Let's take a level 4 ground Gundam. Do we take a beam rifle with us, though? I think we do. Let me take the beam rifle. No, RP, I will. I mean, I just chugged a rain. So I'll be all right. I also have a Red Bull and coffee. And there's like water drinks that have caffeine in them. So if I have to, like, you know, I can do it is what I'm saying. Yo, what up, Amuro? Oh God, they're dropping on our faces. Oh, shut up, Makuve. You suck, dude. Ah, rockets.
What?
Yo, Amuro fucked him up. Is Char behind me? Not yet. The Char's gonna show up too at some point. We gotta be very careful when he shows up. I don't know why this is a very hard mission, because Amuro is not gonna die. Like, the amount of time it would take for him to die would be ridiculous.
I told you so.
Where did you order groceries from, RP? Oh, just Walmart.
He's good. I see it.
No, no. Oh, okay.
Take this.
No. Yeah, like Char is not even hurting Amuro. No one's gonna take him down. Walmart delivery. Yeah.
What? What? Hit it.
Come here. There we go. A little shoulder check. Hey, everyone. I don't know why that's a very hard mission. That was really easy. Oh, that's why you brought up the Pringles. Okay. Oh, does Kayla like salt and vinegar? What is this? Destroy the bra bro. Didn't we do that once already? Wait, then why did you get salt and vinegar? Who likes salt and vinegar? Oh, you saw him online. Okay, I understand. Okay, that makes sense. I was like, what the fuck, dude? Why are you getting chips you don't like? This is a hard mission. So I think we can do it with a 2-star Rick Dom. That's a big maybe though. Because our health pool is gonna be kind of shitty. 520. I think Brabra is the one with the detachable like things. The like wire guided laser like funnels almost. Not funnels, but bits. Something's behind me. Oh, it's the Brabra, okay. Ah! Is it Kalia? I actually don't know who pilots this thing. I don't remember who that is. Enemy. Oh, Sayla's here. Hi, Sayla. This is gonna be a battle of attrition here. What's behind me? Dude, come here. Why are you running? Why are you running? Did you guys ever see that video before? I don't know what it's from, but it's funny. Oh, Amuro should look for this fight too? Hey, what the fuck? Calm down with all that, buddy. I don't know if you can destroy the wire-guided like beam cannons or not on this thing. Amuro almost killed that thing with like 2 slashes. Balanced. Very balanced. Oh, alright, he's dead. She's dead. I don't know. I don't know who Kalia is. Is it Chalia? Kalia? Kalia? Is that a first name or a last name? I don't know. The world may never know. Are we back here? Why is the Elemeth on Solomon? Oh, okay. It's attacking Solomon now that we've taken it. Okay. So we have 2 victory conditions. We have to destroy the Elemeth and end the operation time. Or does it mean either, maybe? Maybe it's either one and you win. Okay, well, we're on ground, though, which is good. So we can take a gun cannon with us, and I think that'll be fine for this fight. Famous last words.
I'll try, Captain.
Is Char with you? That's not good for us, if Char's with you. Also, if we kill Lala here, does that fuck up something? Like, do we not get the space mission then? Oh, I bet it's really hard to actually... Yeah, it's not going to be easy to defeat her here. Oh, we're not even doing damage to her when we hit her. Oh, no, they're shooting at me. And don't forget, she's controlling all those little guys with her mind. She's a new type. So the new type core is actually kind of real, in a sense. I think Lala is like the strongest new type at this point, by far. Like, because Char and Amuro haven't really, I guess, activated their new type powers all the way yet. And Lala's kind of a trigger for them, if I'm remembering correctly. Like, because she helps them unlock more than just being a good pilot. Because, like, the whole, like, sensory thing when they're in the mobile suit and they can, like, feel what's going on around them and stuff. Like, that was already a thing, but, like, she unlocks that more psychological connection. Like, new types are all connected kind of thing. We're getting fucked up right now, though. We're not doing any damage either.
That's it.
What is this song that's playing right now? Wait, this is Char's theme, I think.
Captain Char.
It is. This is the first time we've heard this. Okay, I need to get the fuck out of here. He's gonna fucking wreck me. Yeah. That's cool. They never played his theme before. I forgot the song existed. No. I'm sorry. Leave me alone. Don't kill my gun cannon. Don't kill my gun cannon. If you're wondering about the music choices, remember this came out in the 70s. The end of the 70s. Alright, we survived. Somehow. My good gun cannon got kind of fucked up, though. It's gonna be a while before we can use that again, which sucks, but... Satellite orbit. Zanzibar destroyed. Would've been a good gun cannon mission. Not now, though. What's happening on Earth? Sink a submarine. That seems appropriate now. Go over here. Medea's. Escort some supply cores. Newark. No, we're not doing this. We'll do this one. Alright, we have to destroy a Zanzibar. What do we take to destroy the Zanzibar? Probably something that can shoot a lot. Gun tank is the first, like, you know, go for it, but it's a hard mission. I'll take my regular gun cannon and we'll take the one-star gun tank with us. I don't know. I don't know if any white base people show up here. If not, we should still be okay. Yeah, I think we're gonna be fine. Okay, we don't really do a lot of damage to it with the cannons right now. Just gotta keep doing this, though. Our gun tank should do a good bit of damage, too. Alright, here they come. Zaku 2. Two Zaku 2s. What's up, dude? Oh, no, watch out. I think we're doing all right so far. What the? Talk one. Who are you? I mean, I guess you're the pilot of the Bigro, but okay. I thought we destroyed the Bigro already. Ow. Get away from me, bro. What the fuck? Oh, no. There we go. Alright, that was fine. New type rank of B. Okay. Texas colony. We do one here, we go back to Earth for something. Nothing really is like piquing my interest down here that like seems like we should do it. I mean, they're pretty, like, standard missions down there. We'll just go to Texas Colony and, raid the enemy mobile suit test. We'll take, like, really strong ground units, because we really aren't going to be able to use them soon here. Once we go to a Baoku, because everything will be in space again. What are they? They must be testing a guy, the Gion or whatever. I don't know, unless it's a Gelgoog they're testing over here. Oh, I think it is the Gelgoog. There's one standing right there. Yeah. Arguably, like, well, my second favorite Zeon unit. That friendly fire kind of fucked me right there. That was weird. The upper body of the ground gun wasn't moving there. It was like stuck in place for some reason. Oh, I missed. Ah! Oh, is there a Gelgoog? Yeah, there it is. Why are they not moving? I mean, I know they're testing it, but like they could still move, right? Truly. They can do that. Alright, that one's moving. Okay. Okay. Ow. Oh, actually, exciting Gundam news. If you've never watched the original Mobile Suit Gundam, you can now watch it on Funimation. I think they even have the dub on there. I had to double check that, but they might actually have the dub on there as well as the sub. Which is super exciting. Now, granted, you have to remember going into it, it's from 1979. So it's like, it's an old school anime. So like the art style, like the art in it is like old, you know what I mean? So like, you have to like go in knowing that and kind of knowing the time period to understand like a lot of like to not judge it too harshly, I guess is what I'm saying. Got it. But it still is really good. It's amazing, actually. And I highly recommend it. It's 49 episodes, I think. Is it 49 or 47? It might be 47 episodes, the original now. We also captured a Gelgoog there, which is really good. Is it making us go back to Earth right now for some reason? I guess it is. Let's just go to Newark and do something, I guess. What should we take? Should we take the Gelgoog? Yeah, we'll take the Gelgoog. And we'll also bring a gun tank. Should have saved the Gelgoog, really, for a space mission. But hopefully it doesn't get too fucked up here. And I think we might get one more full repair. In the quest, in like the storyline. Ow. I don't know, this unit is just the best, my favorite to play with in this game, by far. Like, this feels really good. The way it, like, the move, like, the reaction time and stuff on it. Like, you don't really notice it until you, like, go to an older unit and try to move around like this. And, like, there's, like, a delay that happens. And the Gelgoog just feels really clean. Now, I wish it did have, like, a little bit more weapon variety. And, like, our only attack wasn't just really... The spin was our special. Which, I mean, the spin's cool, it blocks everything. Unless you get shot from behind. But I wish it was, like, I don't know, some sort of combo or something like that would be cool. Like, Char's Gelgoog moveset is better than the regular Gelgoog moveset because it can do a little bit more. Still nothing up here, okay. So this is just a destroy enemy units mission. Do that. Do we take a 4-star GM? I feel like the Baoku scenario is starting pretty soon. I don't want to kind of exhaust my resources. Let's go back to Earth then. Let's do an Earth mission. What's the Great Canyon? What's going on there? Alright, you know what? We're gonna go destroy the submarine, because it's easy. And I have a Zagok that's ready to go, and a Zok. We're bringing the water boys, the moist boys, into this fight against the submarine. Speaking of Zoks, they have one. They have two, actually. Alright, our goal is to focus the submarine, though, not the Zoks. Even though we might have to focus the Zoks a little bit. Stop shooting at me! I come in peace! So many large-ass beam rifles being fired right now. Oh, hey, look, it's a Zagok. Brother! Brother, no! For a very easy mission, I'm making this look very hard. I think the reason it's very easy is the Yukon actually doesn't leave the combat area, so you can just kind of take your time in fighting it. I'm not taking my time in fighting it, as you can see. Oh, give me a Gog. This is true thick boy right here. No! See those moves right there? Don't forget them. Dude! Ally! Shoot giant submarine, not enemies. Got him. Easy. Not really, we almost tied. Yeah, I think that mission was mislabeled as very easy. I don't think it was. Still nothing up here. Okay. I guess the war is kind of laying low right now. Alright, so rescue allied mobile suit, allied ground combat, Gundam leaves operation area. So this area we're going to right now in the Himalayas kind of looks like what happens in the 8th MS team. And we're defending a ground Gundam, which is kind of cool. Kind of an homage to that, because 8th MS team does take place during the 1 year war. I don't know if it's an actual like reference or anything, but it's still cool to think to assume it is. Well, let's go ahead and back him up. Oh, watch out, ally. Good job. Whoa, why'd you get so fucked up, bro? What happened? Damn, dude. Zaku looked at you funny, huh? A goof! No! Leave him alone, bro! Alright, we're gonna do this, I guess. Come here. You're supposed to be leaving the operation area, not running in circles in it. Alright, we're going back this way. I'm stuck. Okay. Whoa, calm down there, buddy. Ow. Dude, that ground gun is fucked up. He must have like a non-existent health pool. Block that, okay. Still just running back and forth, huh? No thoughts of escaping or you know, anything like that? Dude, he blocks it again. He does not want to get shoulder checked for some reason. Oh, he got out. Okay, I guess he decided to leave all of a sudden. Oh, that's good.
I'm sending you a mobile suit. It's a V Project prototype, but I hear that its performance is acceptable. Use it wisely.
Please be a gun cannon? It is a gun tank. Thanks, dude. Really, really wanted a gun tank so badly. Apparently this mission won't go away, so we're gonna do it now. What do we take, though? This will probably be okay, right? Fine. Oh, are they running then? Is that what's happening here? Ow. Good start. Oh, is it you who's running? Okay. Okay, I see what we're doing here. Get off my ass, bro. Oh god. Oh, okay, that was not good. Don't get hit by those. We're above it now, so we're safe. Alright, that guy's out of the way now. Ow. Oh wait, never mind, they keep coming. Oh wait, what the hell hit me in the head? Probably a rocket off the ship, I guess. Let's kick it. That colony is actually moving in front of us. That's cool. Usually the backgrounds are kind of stagnant in this game. I never noticed the colony spinning though. That's cool. Nice little touch. I'm probably completely wrong, but I'm gonna say it anyway. I'm pretty sure the reason the colonies spin is to create gravity inside of them. Cutting it a little close, I'd say. Yeah, right there, right? My ally died. Oh no. Fuck, we're gonna die. Oh, they're right on my ass. Oh, okay. That was a little too close for comfort there. We got a new type rank for that too, because we destroyed two new size. Damn, we still aren't moving on to a battle coup. Okay. I guess we'll go back to Earth. Let's bring out the missile launcher because I haven't used it yet, and then also bring a gun tank with us. It's a normal mission, we'll be fine. I'm not a huge fan of this weapon, but it should do the trick, right? Do they fire two at a time? I guess so. Yep, don't like this weapon. I remember why now. Not a fan. The shots track pretty good, I guess, but I don't like it. What the f- Oh, I got hit by friendly fire there. Fuck, he's dodging the shit out of me. Yeah, I don't like this this missile launcher very much. It's like, I don't think you can dodge to the side and fire it, which is like super awkward. Actually killed them with the chest machine gun. Wait, how'd I fire more there? I fired 3 shots there instead of 2. What did I do? Did I hold it down? Oh, if you like... Okay, if you spam press the button, you fire all your shots. That's cool. Did not know that. Okay, that makes it better, admittedly. Did not realize you could do that. Yeah, we're not gonna use that again. I guess it's good to know it's there if we need it, but...
I will relay the mission of Operation Star 1.
Okay.
We will take out the Zeon Space Fortress at Bawakur and invade the Zeon homeland. If we win this battle, this war is over!
Operation Star 1 has... Wait, Operation Star 1 was commenced. We launched from Solomon. We launched from Solomon, and we will attack Zeon's final defense line of Space Fortress Baoku. Alright. Oh, God. Great. We have a hard mission right off the bat. What is it? Oh, okay. It's Char and... It's Char and Amuro and Lala fighting in space. So... What do we even take? Our gun cans gonna get fucked if we take it here. But if we take a GM, we'll probably get one shot. I don't even know what I don't know what to take for this mission. Like, it's not the Gundam probably would be the right answer, but I also don't. What's that Gelgoog like? Is it fixed? No. We're gonna take the Gundam just to be safe. Cause it's a space mission, like an actual floating in space mission, also, which I don't like. And it's also gonna have Lala and Char in it, so we gotta be careful here.
I see it.
Ow.
What difference is that supposed to make?
Lala, stop playing around with me.
Alright, where's Char at? Oh no! Okay, we're okay. I gotta worry about Char.
Not yet. Brother! Brother, stand back!
It's Artesia.
Okay, let's not do that, Char. Chill, brother. Yeah, there we go. Commence the sad music.
People are changing. They're becoming like us.
Oh, fuck. This is gonna be a lot of damage. Ow.
Yeah, I suppose so. You're right about that, Lala. Do you honestly believe
is Char
that?
Leaving? No. You're gonna stick.
Yes, of course. You and I were able to understand each other. One day, people will even be able to control time.
You know, it's funny he says that.
I can see.
Because that kind of happens. After, like, I would say.
I something I can never take.
Once you get into Gundam Unicorn, which is like towards the end of the Universal Century timeline right now, things get a little space magic-y to a more extreme extent than is seen and usually is seen in the Gundam universe. It's pretty cool though. I like it. There's a lot of people who don't enjoy that. I thought it was really cool when they did it. Like, it didn't bother me. But Unicorn and Gundam Narrative both get kind of shit on for that. I'm also not sure. So the original creator of Gundam, I don't remember. Buttsham, this is a real character right now. I don't remember you, but you're dead. I don't know if the original creator wrote Unicorn and Narrative, or if it's like an expansion of his work by someone else. I don't remember. I'd have to look. Because I know a lot of people are complaining about the space wizards, essentially, is what new types become. But it's, I think it's cool. You'd have to watch it yourself and make that judgment call. It is still a lot less overdone than like things like Evangelion. Like, it's nowhere near that extreme. It's like the shit that goes on in Ava, but it does get kind of crazy and abstract in comparison to like the realistic version of war that Mobile Suit Gundam tries to depict. All right, our intelligence is spotty now, but it seems that the Zeon forces used a solar system type weapon and have destroyed much of our fleet. General Revel is included on the list of casualties and MIA. Okay. Okay, Operation Star 1, aggressive recon. Just survive, pretty much. We're gonna need a repair at some point here, I think. Because it's gonna get real sketchy, because a lot of our units are gonna be too damaged to take out. I'm gonna end up using a ball. Watch. There's a Bowaku. That Gelgoog should be repaired soon, though, so we also have that as a backup. We have two Rick Doms also, if we need to use them. I don't really like the Rick Dom too much, though. Like, to play as in this game. What we got? A Gelgoog. Yay. So I really think if Zeon would have gotten the Gelgoog a little bit earlier in the war than they did, because the problem is the Gelgoog actually will compete against the Gundam, but they don't get it till way late in the war, and it's like they're already losing at that point. If they would have gotten it a little bit earlier, it could have made it a bigger impact, I guess, than it actually got to. And it sucks, because it's a really cool unit. The variations of it are also really badass. Like, there's a Jaeger Gelgoog, or Gelgoog Jaeger, it's called, from... I think that's from, 0083 Stardust Memories, I want to say. It's a pretty badass variation of the Gelgoog, and there's a lot of them. Like, there's a Gelgoog Cannon, and other ones besides that. But, like I said, they came up a little bit too late in the war to make a difference, so... Like, I think it might have been, like, one of those situations, I can't remember exactly, where I think maybe only ace pilots got them. Like, they weren't being distributed to, like, the regular, soldiers yet. Like, it wasn't fully mass-produced yet, I guess is the right way to say that. That was a captured ball. It was green. What's up, Smash Brother? The gym customs from 0083, are like that too. Yeah, exactly. The gyms get some crazy ass variations later on as well. But again, like I don't think a lot of them were like you're saying were mass produced either, which kind of sucks. Because like as you, I mean, the base gym is kind of bland, you know. what we're playing with right now. Not much really going on here. Ooh, we're getting a little close here. We gotta just keep it cool for like 15 seconds and we're good. Alright, cool. So we should be moving to the surface of a Baoku here pretty soon, I think. Because the Lala and Char and Omarosan area is over. Oh, we're still up here. Okay. The Operation Star 1 attack on Space Fortress of Baoku has begun. Oh, okay, that's it. Alright, so support fortress attack units. People are just moving through the attack area. Okay, we're going to run into this problem now. We're going to use all of our better units for these beginning missions. We're not going to have anything once we get to a Baoku surface. Because I want to save the gun cannon for that. The Gundam's out of commission for a while, which I think we get a full repair or another Gundam, which we're going to have to rely on that now. We'll take the 2-star Rick Dom. And hopefully that'll do the job. Not the biggest fan of it, but it'll have to work. To hopefully save us for later. It'd be cool if the heat saber would turned pink instead of blue. Because they do change the beams whenever you play as a capture unit from yellow to pink or pink to yellow. That bar is going down real slow. They need to prioritize escaping, not fighting. We hit the shield there. That's why it didn't do any damage. Yeah, I don't know about this mission. Not with this unit. I probably should have took my gun cannon. Because right now, for where we're at, we should be using like 3 or 4-star units, not 2-star, for a hard mission. Especially when their units are just better. The Gelgoo is just better than a Rick Dom. I think he was RP, because he did buy a copy of WoW for Artie, and Artie didn't want to play it. So, we can talk to him whenever he gets on. Or gets back on, if he's not here right now. I paid for looking away right there. Okay, we're gonna die. We're gonna have to pick something else for this mission. I'll take the gun cannon with us. It'll be fine. Back in the day, I probably could have did that mission with a Rick Dom, but not now. Am I gonna walk you through it? So the nice thing is, RP, is with the new expansion for WoW, they put you in a starter area that does walk you through the beginning of the game and explains everything. So, all right, the fierce battle of Baoku rages on. All right, we're still going here, dude. Maybe we'll just take the Gelgoog is almost full repair. Maybe we'll just take it for this mission. I can definitely do this mission with the Gelgoog. I think it'll be fine, RP. Imagine playing your, it's like 14. Like, it's the same kind of layout of the game. With like your buttons and whatnot. You just gotta pick a class that you wanna play. Is there a lot of forced party stuff? I mean, dungeons and whatnot are with parties still. It's the same concept as Final Fantasy 14. See, I'm the opposite. I think the dungeon, the group content is the most fun in an MMO. That content's usually a lot better than the single player content also. But also, RP, if you're doing that stuff with friends, it's a lot more fun than by yourself. Yeah, exactly, RP. So if you're playing with other people, it's a lot more enjoyable than doing it by yourself. Even with us, we'll probably still have some randoms in the party. Dude, fucking chill over there, Mr. Gelgoog. I understand you're like a badass unit, but you're fucking me up right now. God, I need to take my freaking Gundam out. Oh, hold on 1 second. She ran away. There was a cat at the door. A cat at the door, but she turned around and ran away when I opened the door. I mean, the door was, it was cracked. She could have fit through, but she was just being hesitant. Alright, I think we're okay. We're at half health. That bar is going down real slow, but is it either if they escape, we win? Yeah. Okay. Ow. Just send the. Okay, here's another Gelgoog. Too early. Oh no, it's gonna hit me. Yeah, that was bad. That was real bad. Alright, GM, get out of here. Run! Not the. Yeah, go. Go. You. Got him. Oh wait, didn't realize there was one behind us too. I almost flew into that. Oh, did he die? No, that was a ball that died, okay. All right, that GM's escaping, one more. Oh, the beam rifle noises? They sound like DBZ teleport noises? They do kind of now that you're saying that. I never, like, thought of it that way before. They kind of do sound like that, though. Like, extremely similar now that you brought that up. You want that noise for your phone every time someone texts you? Fuck, he died. That was the last one I needed to get out too. That sucks. All right, this guy gotta survive. We have to activate human shield mode now. Even though we're gonna die like in one more hit also. And then we'd friendly fire him. Thank goodness. I was gonna say, if he's not running, he's gonna die. That was a struggle right there. Those like missions in space where you're actually floating in space are always rough. Which we have another one. Okay. I do think the GMs recover pretty fast. But we should be able to do this with a regular gun cannon, I think. So far, so good. I have a feeling if one of those ships goes down, we're gonna lose a lot of that bar at one time. Great, Gelgoogs now. Really? Okay. Bees. I wish they had health bars so you could see how bad it was for them right now. Because one of them got to be getting a little low, I think. This game really could use like GM snipers and stuff. That'd have been really cool to play as. Even Gundam versus Data Gundam didn't add any of the variant units to the game, sadly. Arguably the coolest mobile suits, like from the OVAs and whatnot. I'm pretty sure they only like stick to the original like Gundam Zeta Gundam canon units in both games. Even though the OVAs have some of the really, really badass versions of all these guys. Oh, there goes one. Oh, it's half the bar if one dies. Okay, so if both die, it's over. Okay, that's awesome. Only 30 more seconds, right? We'll be fine. The Gelgoogs really... I said they weren't making an impact in the war. Well, they're making an impact in this campaign right now. Alright, we won. Whew! Close. A little too close for comfort, because that ship could have been really low and we wouldn't have known. Damn it, another one. Destroy enemy cruiser, another Zanzibar to destroy. Okay. We are getting thrown a lot of missions this time. What we got here? I think I have to use him. Full siege mode. See how this goes. Probably gonna be fine. Just focus the Zanzibar down. The gun tank seems to distract them pretty well. I just sit here and do this. And I don't believe the guns can hit me up here because I don't think they tilt upwards. And now it's gone anyway, so it doesn't matter. Oh, watch out! Watch out! Alright, that wasn't too bad. That went pretty clean, I think. So that gun cannon should only take one or two missions, hopefully, to get repaired, and we can use it again. I mean, worst case scenario, we can take it out if it's not in perfect health. Oh, we also got a new one there. That's a 3-star, then. Alright, secure operational foothold. Just win the battle, pretty much. Okay. I could try the gun tank. This is a little bit of a risk for me. This is not the greatest unit to play as. She can't really move very much, but if we one-shot stuff, it might be fine. It's a 2-star, so. Thanks, RP. We're the Federation thick boy now. Ow. A tank boy, look at this. Boom. So this is a very dangerous unit to play as or be in, because like the gunner is in the top of that, and there's like it's like the reinforced glass like visor cover there. Like the pilot in the cockpit at least has like armor plating in front of him. If you're the gunner and you get hit by like a stray missile, you're dead. I never understood that design. Because like the center, like the pilot, the you can't really tell, but like where the blue and the red are is where the like the driver is. But if you're gunning, dude, you're like just out in the open right there. One unfortunate headshot and you're dead. Now I'm sure like a Zaku machine gun probably wouldn't do it, but like, you know, especially when you get to the beam weapon time, like it wouldn't take much, I wouldn't think. Ow. Gave me a hug. I'm gonna destroy that Bigro. I'm gonna get it. Maybe. Oh my gosh. Come straight at. I'm gonna get like dizzy with this damn thing. Dude, no tracking at all on any of my weapons. Got him. That was annoying. All right, one more unit and we're good to go. Yo, what up, Dalton? You home now? RP had questions for you about WoW. You sold that ring for 200K you found earlier? Congrats on being rich in WoW now. Congrats on gold, dude. I want some gold. Send me 100K. Spread the love. Destroy Musai. Okay. I mean, but I'm uber poor in WoW. So make me less uber poor in WoW. I could use some monies in that game, please. We're gonna take the damage gun cannon. I think we'll be fine. We just have to destroy a cruiser, which isn't on the surface sounding like it's gonna be too bad. I think it just flies around the map the whole time. This actually would have been a better gun tank mission, I think. I don't know though, because it's moving pretty fast. And the gun tank's pretty slow, so maybe it would be hard to keep up with it. Like, it's cruising right now. Look at this thing. Who's shooting me? What do you want, dude? Come on. Oh, wait. Let's do this. Oh. Wow, that dodge was real close. Oh, great. A Gelgud. Probably gonna kill my ally. Look at him just manhandling him. Oh, look at that. Shot after shot. Stop it! Fight me. Alright. Gun Tank can handle that Rick Dom. I'm going after the Musa again. I think we're going to be fine. There we go. I don't actually know who got the kill there. The gun tank might have. Nope, it was me. Got that new type rank again also. Alright, what is going on over here now? Destroy enemy units. This sounds like a really bad time, but it's the only mission we can do. So what are we going to do? Do we take the GM? I don't know. This is not going to be good either way. What's up, RP? So it tells you have two more bosses, I think, and then access to all the side stuff. Okay, so we have... That means we have Melchior and then somebody else, and then we have, the game lets you do whatever you want to do before you end it, I'm guessing. Alright, what do we do here? We can take a four-star GM, I guess. But if we do get destroyed, we get to relaunch. Zock it to him. Imagine if the Zock went into space, how that would work. Let's just take this out. Let's see what we can do here. I probably should have taken a weaker one and just let it die, but... ERP, Shigure was the last boss that I fought in Tales of Berseria last time. Wow. Wow, that GM did no damage to this guy, so we have to kill everything then. I feel like we didn't do as many of these like free-floating space missions as Zeon. We've got a lot with the Federation. Oh, great. Here we go. Alright, well, his shield's gone now. The nice thing about having this 4-star GM is that it has a lot of ammo. So, RP, how many more bosses are left in the game then? Like, 3? If there's 2 more before we can, like, do the final free room stuff? Got him. Oh, what? Really? Oh, alright. We got Rick Dom. Wow, we actually blocked the Gelgoo shot with our shield. There we go. Some RNG right there, finally in our favor. Alright, what we got? Gelgoo behind me. Gelgoo. Oh, wait, there's 4 or 5 bosses left in the game, IP? Really? Yeah, the question is, oh no. Oh no. Where's he at? Oh god, leave me alone, Char. I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it, dude. No, I'm sorry. Oh, get out of my face! Oh, we look, one shot, 200 health gone. Oh, great. Come on. We're gonna be relaunching here pretty soon, I think. Alright, I can do this. You can't hit me. Okay, and he gets me from the side. Ooh, 600 health. This is a thick boy right now. We got a high-level gun cannon. Hey, Shark, can you leave now? Go fight Amuro. Wasn't this a hard mission? Not a very... Oh, he left already. He just came here to make my life miserable, kill my unit, and fly away. Nice, dude. Thanks. Alright, just gotta kill this guy and we're done! And I'm down a 4-star GM. Jim. Old Jimbo. Oh, dude, I agree 100%. Any pilot that was in GM and saw that thing coming at them, they knew they were fucked. Yeah, there was like no way you'd be able to survive that. Just because, like, even like if you were like the greatest pilot ever, the GM wouldn't be as like advanced enough mobile suit to avoid the Zeong. So, oh well. End operation. All right, what are we bringing now? All right, if we die, we die, right? Yeah. Okay. I'm trying to remember, we're going to have a few missions inside of a Baoku still, so I don't want to, like, completely run out of stuff to use. What's up, Sloggy? Playing Borderlands 3. There you go. A fun game. Me and RP played that a while back on stream. Oh, wait, no, we played Borderlands 2. Never mind. Never played Borderlands 3. It looked good. Never checked it out, though. Can we get away with the gun tank, you think? Well, we're gonna find out if we can. I think that Amuro and Char show up in this mission again, so being an extremely immobile unit is not gonna be good against Char, but we'll do the best we can. Yeah, I corrected myself, RP. I realized that after I said that. We're gonna get there eventually. I honestly don't remember them using the gun tank in space in the original Mobile Suit Gundam. They might, but I don't remember it. I've actually never played the original Borderlands before the Sloggy. I don't really have an interest in playing it right now, but I'm guessing it must be pretty good if they spent the time to enhance it and re-release it, right? Sad space music. Oh, thanks, dude. You didn't have to shoot me in the shoulder like that. Inappropriate. Okay, so you opened a ticket with the customer service refund from Artie, so he doesn't want it. Do the recruiter friend with RP so you can at least play while you wait when your stream is over. Okay. I have to figure out how to do recruiter friend in WoW. Never did that before. I can believe that Sloggy, the original, being a little rough around the edges. So wait, are you playing Borderlands 3 with mouse and keyboard then? Oh, okay, it's pretty straightforward then. RP, do you have a Battle.net account? If you're listening. Because you would, I think, need to have that and probably install a game. I don't know, hopefully Dalton explained all that to you. Oh yeah, for Diablo 3, exactly. That is a good point. We've played Diablo 3 plenty of times, I should have known that. I think I might already have it, actually, Sloggy, because I think when I bought Borderlands 2, I bought, like, a combo pack off of Steam. Hey, there's Amuro. Is the Gundam missing an arm? It is missing an arm. That's cool. Yeah, I'm realizing... Oh, my bad, dude. I realized that. We just talked about that RP. Did you start that new Diablo season yet? I wonder if we can... Oh, we might get to see the Gundam with its head blown off too here, and probably get to see Char Zeong's body get destroyed here at some point. Hey, dude. Hey, easy with those hand beams. Yeah. So probably once we get inside of Baoku, we can see the Zeong head floating around, which would be pretty cool. Cause we didn't get to see it on the Zeong campaign. I gotta back up before I get killed. Alright, he's gone now, I think. Yep. Alright, we won. Dude, one shot from Char, man, really fucks you up. Same with Amuro. I think Amuro was harder to deal with in the Zeon campaign than Char is, though. Amuro wants all the glory? Oh, for sure. Okay, I hope we get to see the Zeon head, though, because it looks kind of funny with it floating around while everything's going on. We also got a tier one-star Gundam now, I think. Yes, so we're saving one-star Gundam for the last mission. I don't know how many missions out of Baoku we have. Maybe like three? So, take this. Yeah, if we get to see the Zeon, it's funny. I think you can lock onto it and fight it, I'm pretty sure. The head of the Zeon, I mean, not the entire Zeon. I don't know, RP. I would ask Dalton. He's the WoW expert. Aw, no! Why is there a ball in here? Like, that's not what you want to use against these units. And the only reason the Federation won the goddamn war is because of the white base. And Amuro. Coming at Gelgu with little balls. Come on now. Oh! Oh, that was right in the face too. The pilot of that ball has the biggest balls in the entire game. He said he just went up to a Gelgoog and poked him with his little claws. Oh, I'm surrounded as fuck. Holy shit. Okay, hold on. Get out, get out. Whew. $19 for Borderlands 3 is a pretty good deal, I think. What is it normally, Sloggy? Like 40? Oh god, he got me there. God, they're throwing all the Gelgoogs at us. Okay, this is not getting a, this is getting a little sketchy. Oh god. Hold on, okay. Fuck, okay, we're still alive. We get to relaunch, so it's not the end of the world if we go down here. As I was saying. What do we get? A GM, oh god, it's a weak-ass GM too. It only has 440 health. Okay. We need to kill like two more units and we win though. Yo, thanks for the support, RP. But I got it, we'll see. Actually, if it's a the Rikdon might have finished it. I think a Zaku 2 wouldn't actually take the bar down the whole way. Ally, thank you. Shoot him. That was a stupid idea. Alright, we won. Our gun cannon bit the dust, though. Little derpy GM just fucking shit up. Somehow. Alright, what's going on outside? Support allied bombard unit? No. Infiltrate. Alright, what's the mission parameters here in this one? Allied battle strength is 0. That GM actually got repaired really fast. Yeah, we're not using this Gelgoog again. Gym feet sound like oil cans. Yeah, they kind of do. What do we do here? We take the gun cannon again? Or what's the outside? What's going on here? We have to defend the gun tanks that are up top pretty much. I think we just do the infiltrate a Baoku mission again. Take a less than perfect gun cannon with us. I'm sure that'll be fine, right? How bad could it go? I was actually fine last mission until the Gelgoog swarmed us. Then I was like, okay, can't dodge fast enough for that. We are a mid-support unit, not a frontline unit. So, I mean... I like this music, though, for Inside of a Baoku. Well, like, towards the end of the game, you get this track now. I don't know if it's exclusive to a Baoku or not. God damn it, they're coming in already. Okay. I miss? Seriously? There we go. It's behind me. Izaku 2, I can live with that. I would put WoW in your SSD RP. Because it has to load a lot of stuff in every time it launches. And it really, really helps with load times. Alright, so far so good. We just can't die this time. That's the big difference from last time. One of my shots hit my ally. I don't know how big the download is for WoW either RP. I think it's a pretty substantial size file. Got him. What the hell was that shot? He's aiming at right there. gigabytes. That sounds about right. I thought it was 80, so yeah, quite right. Borderlands 3 is 86 gigabytes. Really? It seems really large. Like unnecessarily large download. That's without DLC? Damn. Oh no. I can't 1v1 a Gelgoog. Maybe I can. Huh. Got him. I missed, but I got him. That hitbox, though. No sweat. Easy. Borderlands 3 is still $60 regularly. That's actually surprising it costs that much. Alright, so we're defending the white base. The old Trojan horse. What are we defending it with, guys? We can take a damaged Gundam. That actually might be our best bet. I'm gonna do it. We're launching with a damaged Gundam. We'll save the good Gundam for the next very hard mission in here, which we'll have another one here soon, I think. So what are we at? About almost half health? That's a... Do you copy? Yeah, I'm here.
Due to engine failure, we have made an emergency landing on a Baoku. Requesting escort.
Yeah, sure, Frau. I'm fine. I'll
switching to hand-to-hand combat.
You don't have any units on you right now, I don't think. Or do you have Kai and Hayato still? Maybe they sent somebody out to help.
What are you doing?
Shut up, Bright. Got you. Got you, bro. Each DLC is $15 a piece still, too. I didn't think Borderlands 3, like, sold very well, so I'm surprised that it's still so expensive.
What are you doing?
Hey, there we go. Oh, I guess they still have the gun tank in space then. Would have preferred the gun cannon, but I'll take it for Hayato. I probably won't play Borderlands 3, to be honest with you, Dylan. Not anytime soon, at least. Ow. They're not doing a very good job of distracting these guys, that's for sure.
Darn it.
The combos and shit you can do in Gundam vs. Zeta Gundam are wild compared to what's in this game. This game's very, like, well, remember, it came out before it. This game did. This is, like, the predecessor to Gundam vs. Zeta Gundam. But they really expand on the movesets of your units. Not so much the originals, but the Zeta Gundam units. So it's pretty cool, and you have transformations and stuff, which is pretty cool, and like these hyper modes you can go into. It's actually really cool. We'll have to play some of it at some point. So the campaign, I think I talked about this before, isn't laid out the same way. It's kind of like character-driven storylines, not just being a soldier in the 1 year war. Well, Data Gundam's after the 1 year war, but the way they go about it's a little different. It's more like main character-driven. And like scenario driven, which isn't necessarily bad, it's just different than this. We have to be careful also, because I'm gonna die. What is this music? It's the old tracks from the original Mobile Suit Gundam TZ. You gotta remember, it's from 1979, so bear with it. Honestly, if we just, like, walked away, they probably still couldn't defeat White Base at this point. Yeah, exactly, Smash. They're, like, alternate what-if branches to the storylines, which is kind of cool. It just, there's a lot of grinding that goes into it to get all the different scenarios unlocked. Because eventually you get into the ZZ Gundam timeline. Because you can unlock the Double Z Gundam, and they also, you can unlock, what is it called? Oh, fuck. It's the, Kubli Mark II. But that takes a long time to get there. And I think there's also a Shars... I think there's also a Shars counterattack scenario you can try out. But the units aren't in the game. So it's kind of awkward. They're in different units. But the Sasabi and New Gundam sadly aren't in it. Which would have been badass. But I'm pretty sure that... this game and Gundam vs. Zeta Gundam were originally arcade games. So that could be why you get some of the choices and some of the decisions that you see like being made for this gimmick, for example. So that's probably why you have the units you have and not like all the... they didn't put like necessarily like put in all those other units that you could have... they could have. Took you all summer to 100%. It took me a long time back in the day to 100% that. Because you actually get a percentage tracker, right? For each faction, maybe? Or is it overall? It's been a long time since I've played, but I know that you could see your percentage complete. Alright, we won. Whew. That was a little sketchy there for a second. I mean, spoiler alert, White Base gets destroyed anyway. Alright, what we got here? Final mission. Destroy enemy cruiser. Is there any part of the Gundam lore you wish they'd make more stuff for? So, I would want, if they would, like, if I could, like, choose, like, an era for them to do more stuff with, it would be, so, after the 1 year war, you have, like, 0080 War in the Pocket, you have, 0083 Stardust Memories, you have, I believe the 8th MS team take, if the 8th MS team, takes place during the 1 year war, so I would like more stuff in between 0079 and 0083, like, that era would be cool. And what they're actually doing right now, with the Origin series and stuff, they're kind of like redoing the original Mobile Suit Gundam, kind of like an OVA format, not like an episode format, like half-hour episode breakdown. It's more of like hour-long episodes, and there's only a couple of them. It'd be really cool if they said, okay, let's redo the original Mobile Suit Gundam 0079 timeline, 1 year war. I don't think they're going to do that, but if they did, that's probably what I'd like to see, because they, in the Origin series, they started, like, redesigning some of the units and whatnot, and it's pretty badass. It's pretty cool, with what they're doing with it. Yeah, like Zeta New Translation, exactly like that, yeah. Yeah. So I'd be like, I think that'd be pretty cool to see that. But I don't know if they'll ever do that. If they did, that'd be cool. So the new movie that's coming out, Hathaway's Flash, takes place after, Mobile Suit Gundam Unicorn, or narrative, I guess. So they're continuing the timeline. I'd like them to go back and make a new series of the 1 year war. So maybe they will, who knows? All right, final mission, we're taking the Gundam. Let's take our trusty gun tank ally with us as well. You were getting max download speed RP, but you're not survive, now. Oh, shut up, Cassilia.
Is there a delay?
You literally get blown up here in a second anyway. By your boy Char, who's not really your boy at all. A mobile suit! I think Smash, that a lot of people have wanted that for a long time. Because, I mean, sadly, the original 0079 didn't age super well. I mean, it's like, what, how old is it now? Like 40 something years old? Yeah, so I mean, like, understandably didn't age very well compared to what you see now. So it'd be cool if they went back and, like, just took another shot at it. Because Tomino, the original creator, is still alive. So he could definitely be a part of that project if he wanted to be. Yeah, exactly. So that's like 41 years ago it came out. I mean, you can only expect the anime to last, like, a lot of stuff's changed since then. And I think if they could do it justice now, for sure. Oh, we need to get shooting at this thing. Thanks, Cassilia. They know the ship's under attack. I'm right here. My poor gun tank is getting his ass kicked down there. Oh god, he landed up here. The AI's learning! Fall off? Yes. And with that, the Zanzibar goes down. No Char and Amuro in here, though. That's kind of surprising. Enjoy the cutscene. There's still so much Gunpla from the early 80s. Oh, I'm sure, yeah. There's so much, like, manga from Gundam they've never, like, covered in an anime style, so they could definitely do some stuff. It'll never be built. There's a lot they could do with it, because there's a lot of side stories that are really badass they could make shows about, too. Like, Xeonic Front, the game we played, oh, wow, maybe, like, a year ago now. That side story was never made into like any kind of anime or anything like that. I think it's just a manga. So it'd be cool to see that as an anime, because there's enough content there for it for sure. And that story is actually really cool. But there's a lot of instances like that where they have material if they want to cover it. If Amuro hadn't called out to us, those flames would have enveloped
everyone in White Base. You mean Amuro isn't here, Bright?
There's the head.
No, he's not. I guess you and Mirai would be able to hear Amuro better than me.
What?
Sayla, you're the daughter of Zeon. I'm sure you're the closest here to a new type. Search for Amuro on our behalf.
But how? I don't understand. I heard Amuro's voice a little while ago, right?
Yeah.
I could hear him. Oh, it's the kids. White Base. Amuro.
Dude, Smash, have you ever looked into Wing Gundam Glory to the Losers?
There's no way.
There's some badass mobile suits in that. I did see the voice actor for Troa died recently. That is super sad.
Yeah.
So they'd have to like do something about that, I guess, right?
Kika?
Yeah, right.
Okay, now straight ahead.
Everyone on the White Base was new type sensitive, which is why they can find Amuro right now.
This way, just do it. You're almost outside.
But yeah, the Glory to the Losers designs. Look at the Talgi's design from that. It's wild. I kind of wish they would have put the sword fight in this game. It's in Encounters in Space. You get to do the sword fight between Amuro and Char from both sides.
Sorry, Lava. I still have a place to go home to, and nothing could make me happier. I'm sure you understand. We can be together anytime we want to, Lala.
Remember, Lala died, but he's still able to talk to her through space magic. You like the character you picked in Borderlands 3, Sloggy? Oh, the guy with the pet? Yeah, he looked cool. Is there anything...
On this day, oh, yeah. Universal Century 0080, as the sounds of battle begin to fade away, the Earth Federation government and the Principality of Zeon sign a peace treaty signifying an end to this brutal war.
It's also whenever... what is his name? Remy? From War in the Pocket, one of the saddest fucking movies ever. He also died right then. R.I.P. Alright, what do we get here? We're a lieutenant commander. I think we got commander as Zeon. Yeah, I agree, Smash. They probably wouldn't be able to get every voice actor. But they probably would get a good bit, I bet. I bet a lot of those people are still around. From Wing, especially. The original Mobile Suit Gundam, that'd be kind of hard, I think. I don't know if all of those voice actors are still around. Because I think Char has a different voice actor in the Origin series. Not confirming that. Don't take that as like gospel, but I think he does. We got Dimitri again. We're only a standard pilot, guys. Game over. Not really game over. RP! Kill the bot! RP, kill the bot! Or do I have to do it? I can do it. I'll give you like 1 second, then I'll do it. Alright, I got it. Got this. Oh no, he beat me to it! I was about to press it! Alright, whatever. Whatever, dude. I thought these had difficulties relating to them. I guess they don't. So one of the cool things in arcade mode, if you type in a character's name, you get to play as them. At least I thought you could. I thought Char was one of them. Was he not?
And may the glory there he of victory is. Be yours.
Okay, there he is. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure Char, you can play as the characters if you type their name in. I've mentioned this before, but like in all the games we play, I always name my character Castfall. That's Char's real name.
All clear, ready to launch.
Roger.
Good luck to you.
I thought we... Okay, if you play as the Guff, you stand up on the ground.
Let's just see. Let's test the
reaction. Oh, we get Char's music too. Oh, shit. That's actually kind of funny. So playing as Char's Gelgoog is very bad, because if you die, that bar basically goes all the way down. Yeah, Char's theme is fucking fire. Good. Defend! Bitch. Whoa! Yeah, look at that. Look how much... So much of that bar goes away so quickly. Thanks, RP, for getting that bot. You're the real MVP. Only 57 gigabytes left.
Mission complete.
I don't
please return.
Think we get anything special for doing this. I forget how many missions are in the arcade mode. It might depend on where you start at, too.
Enemy contact at Great Canyon. Protect allied mobile suits from attack.
Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit.
I will check out Loppy said RP. I'm gonna ruin my stream tomorrow by making me play as him the whole time in Tails. Can't have fun with the end of the game.
What are you doing?
Yeah, that was uncool, ally. The like the hyper modes they add in Gundam vs. Zeta Gundam are really cool because like you can have your units get blown apart and keep fighting and stuff like that. It's actually really cool. We're definitely gonna have to play that at some point. I think the next like retro game, like from like the PS2 era we're gonna cover might be Armored Core 3. I think. That's what I'm kinda leaning towards right now. Better fill up on life bottles. We're gonna need them. I mean, I could just play Loppy Set as a support character RP. I think it'll work. Oh, and I confirmed. I was talking about this the other day. I couldn't remember if the Zeong had wire-controlled arms. It does. In the game, there's no wires, but like in like the anime and manga and everything, they're wire-controlled whenever he does this right here. Yeah, Smash. I remember always using the one where if you got destroyed, you got to come back. That's the one like I always ran, I think. Especially because if I'm remembering correctly, there's like actually difficult boss fights in that game, right? Like they're not as easy as like a lot of the stuff in this game is. Because they were going for more of that single player experience, I think. Because, right, like, for example, in this game, if you're going to fight Amuro and Char in the main story, they're essentially going to one-shot you or two-shot you. That game made, like, actual boss fights, I would say, a little more reasonable. Yeah, RP, you have to make a character.
That's it.
They're not joking, Char. You're getting your ass kicked, bro. You got him. Surely one of my hands will hit. Or not. Got him. Dude, talking about Gundam vs. Zeta Gundam really makes me want to play it now. But I think it would be fun to cover Armored Core 3 because there's a lot of depth to that game, and it's a From Software game, and we love From Software around here. So, Sirocco, Haman, and Camille make you cry. Yeah, I remember. I think it was It probably was Hamon. You fight all of them a lot, though, now that I think about it. I remember Soraka being a problem in the, like, in... Maybe I'm thinking of Camille being the big one, though. Oh, Jared's another one. You fight Jared a lot in it, too. Hey, there's the Gundam.
That's it. There. I told you so. Who cares as long as it doesn't hit us?
Damn. There's just so many more units in that game. You have, like, the Psycho Gundams in it also. All the different grunt units they come out with. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to play that at some point. And then you also have all the units that are in this game as well. I don't think they added any older units from this era, though, sadly. They're all, like, Zeta Gundam and on. Yeah, and all the final fights are at the place with the solar panels that have that really awkward gravitational pull. I remember, because you can kind of use them to kind of maneuver and dodge attacks. Reaction time of your brand new mobile suit. There. The G-Bull. Oh, fuck you. There. Alright, maybe playing as an actual character was the wrong move. They comment on what you do a lot.
That's it. There.
Yeah. Yeah, Smash, you get to go and do some of the 1 year war timelines, but I don't think they added additional units like to the 1 year war era, right? It's the same units as this game, I'm pretty sure. Because, like, I know a lot of the pilots you start off with from Zeta Gundam have 1 year war storylines. But I think they don't add any units, sadly, which is what I would have liked. Some of the variations of different units and whatnot. But I did remember, you have to, like, play through a good bit of the Zeta Gundam stuff to unlock the 1 year war timeline for some of the characters. Because, like, a lot of the people who are a part of the AUK have 1 year war timelines playing or fighting as the Federation. Or, I'm sorry, as Zeon, rather. Dude, that's the one I would have... The Guff Custom and the Camphor are the two that I would have liked to have seen. But sadly, they're never put in anything. Like, the only game... There's, like, two games where I've played as the Camphor. It's the, Encounters in Space... Well, three. Encounters in Space, you can play as it... You can play as it in, Journey to Jaburo. And then also Mobile Suit Gundam Crossfire. And sadly, Journey to Jaburo and Crossfire are kind of rough games. You must be joking. I've got him. I can see the enemy. I told you so. And I don't think that. Mission failed. Oh, seriously?
Can we help? Retreating.
Retreating. I think we can start over the mission. Change our mobile suits up. Yeah, the Guff Custom definitely does not get a love, sadly. The Camphor amazingly made it into Journey to Jaburo and a few other games, but it's very sparse. Like, I think it's the last unit you unlock playing as Zeon in Mobile Suit Gundam Crossfire, which sadly is a trash game. It's like, it had so much potential and they fucked it up so bad. And yeah, Journey to Jaburo's frame rate, I remember that. That's not good either.
May the glory of victory be yours.
Thankfully, the Versus games and Zeonic Front don't really suffer from frame rate issues. Detected an enemy unit in satellite orbit.
Destroy the enemy. Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit. There.
I've got you.
Yeah.
got him. I can see like Journey to Jaburo as a premise is such a cool game, especially whenever you can play as Zeon in the Federation and like unlock all the units from all the different OVAs and stuff. It's just that the engine for the game is not that great and it feels super wonky. Even back in the day, it felt super wonky. Like, they could do so much with it. Like, they could, it, almost like if they could add the engine of this game to Journey to Jaburo or something like that. I don't know. There are things they could have done. Like, I think they could smoothen things out. Like, the boosting in the game felt a little off, I think. It's been a while, though. I don't really remember. But I do remember all the units having, a couple different abilities and whatnot. That's it. That is true. The weight thing of, like, a mobile suit is there. 100%, I agree with. And I guess from that perspective, Mobile Suit Gundam Crossfire does a pretty good job at it as well. Honestly, if they ever try to do something with it, they should take Gundam Battle Operation 2 and use that engine. Because I don't know if you ever played that before. It's the competitive Gundam game on PlayStation. It's a pretty... It feels really good, actually. So if they were ever to redo anything like that, that's what they should use as a basis. But then again, I don't know. Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit. It's been a long time since we've got a good Gundam game. Outside of, like, the strategy game Crossrays, because Mobile Suit Gundam Crossrays was really fucking good. If you ever get a chance, if you like kind of like grid-based strategy games, it's very fun. So you have Crossrays, which is the newest one, which focuses on like the advanced universes, like Iron-Blooded Orphans, Seed, Wing, like those kind of things. And then, hold on 1 second, I gotta find it. I don't know what it's called, but there's a 1 year war one for PS4 as well. All right, it is Mobile Suit Gundam G Generation Genesis. This guy right here. You ever get the chance to get this? It's unopened. I haven't played it yet, but it's the same kind of engine as Crossrays, but all 1 year war, and you can do it through all the different OVAs and stuff. So we're playing that at some point. It just, the thing is, for like a stream format, the battles take a long time, like somewhere like an hour and a half to 2 hours, depending on how big they are. So it's kind of rough for a stream format for me, because a lot of my streams only go for about 3 hours. So sometimes we're only covering like, you know, one battle, maybe two per stream, and there's a lot of battles. Also, thank you for the follow, Smash. We've won. Easy. Your Ning Wong is insane, doing 30k damage on your alts. Holy shit. How much do you grind her up? I still have not played any of the new stuff for Genshin.
With enemy unit in the forest.
I got a G-Fighter here. Destroy, oh, it's going to fly then. Unit. Okay, that's going to be annoying. We're probably not going to fight it. We'll fight the gun tanks. Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit. Die. Hey, easy there, buddy. If we die again, I'm bringing the guff out. I'm gonna fucking shit on people. It is much better against these gun tanks, that's for sure. Whoa, easy there, boys. Please. Oh. Alright, we're bringing the guff out. Oh, the Gundam showed up. That's not good for us. So this is kind of the problem with playing one of these higher tier mobile suits and not being really good at the game. All right, we're going to bring out our grunt units now. Yeah, the boy. The regular Gelgoog.
May the glory of victory be yours.
Big oof there, TZ, I agree.
Contact with enemy unit in the forest.
Destroy the enemy mobile. We're gonna recreate that scene from 8th MS team where the Guff Custom just shits on a bunch of gun tanks. Or we get or it outplays us. We've been outplayed. Ooh, blocked it. So thankfully, playing as the Guff, whatever you want to call it. I know it's a goof, but I call it a Guff.
Who cares as long as it doesn't have damage?
It's okay to die. Guillen is glorious in versus. He is glorious. He is actually really good, especially close range, man. He just fucks shit up. I'm just not like a huge fan of that unit. No RP. I'm just doing the arcade mode real quick. Just playing it through once a Zeon. Oh god. Smack him. I don't know what I'm doing, Char. I'm sorry, man. Oh, we are in danger. Oh god. It's rough out here right now. We're gonna beat this damn mission. I'm gonna do it with the Guff, too. I believe in myself. No, I meant to say no, but it's okay. We said yes. Smash, you want to see the Guillen? The Guillen? Guillen? I'm not that great with it, but I'll play as it.
And may the glory of victory be yours.
The nice thing is, the shield takes a lot of shots before it breaks, because it's your main weapon. That is insane, Sloggy. You grinded her up really fast.
Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit.
Okay, Char. Ha! Rockets! More rockets! Alright, I'm going for the guy in the back. Stabbies. Just give him the stabbo. Got him. You're next. Oh wait, is that armor? Oh no, that was Sharp making that noise, I think. Just like no damage. Oh, we shit on him that time, of course. The gallop, though. Yeah, it's super funny to watch it move around. All right, that actually went a million times better than I thought it was going to. You'd love to experience some kind of zero gravity room or something like that. Like, not going to space, but in a simulated room. That would be crazy. Yeah, I've never done anything like that before. That would be cool, though.
Let's just see. Let's test the
I'm pretty sure that's a thing. Ow. Ow. Holy shit, boys. Why? What did I do to deserve that?
Who cares as long as it doesn't hurt us?
Oof. I'm pretty sure it is RP.
That's it. Right. That's it.
I like that attack right there. And oh, not that one. The stabbo. Yeah, that guy right there.
That's it.
Nope, shield up. I put the shield up.
But
whatever.
I'm a new type as well.
My Thanksgiving was pretty good, Sloggy. Pretty low key. How was yours?
That's it.
We've won.
You want the op? And the opposite, like an extra gravity room like Vegeta goes in. No, I don't think there's a... Oh, like when Goku and Vegeta do the training, or is it just Vegeta? When he's in like the room... Yeah, I don't think that exists, sadly.
Attacking Federation HQ,
That is true, yeah. The planes that go into the high, go high into the atmosphere, let you experience zero gravity. Turkey turns out amazing. That's good to hear, Sloggy. Oh, we get the Jaburo song again. I have this song in a playlist. I gotta find it. I forget what it's called. But this song is on Spotify. Oh, I'm sure it's extremely expensive to do that. Don't get cocky. Don't get cocky. Really? My own mines hit me? We are taking a little bit of damage. No, I think there's commercial things you can do like that, RP. Not just like military DRG. I want to say the rooms exist though for some reason. Maybe I might be crazy though. I could be thinking of something else. True banger right here, boys. No idea what they're saying. But it's not, I'm telling you right now, if we were attacking Jaburo, I'd be hyped right now if this is playing. Please just die. Holy shit.
What are you doing?
Yeah, what are you doing? Ooh, that was real close.
Please return.
Over half your 14-pound turkey is gone already. Goddamn. Oh, do you think the song plays on the pilot or the or on the planet or in the pilot's head? I would say the song plays in the cockpit of the mobile suit you're in. Yeah. Yeah. If I had to guess.
Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit. That's it.
Why is this arcade mode so long? I don't remember it being this many missions. Oh no, I missed. You think the song just playing on loop on the planet on Earth right now?
That's it. I've got it. I can see the enemy.
I don't know what that was there. Ignore what just happened.
I'm a new type as well.
We know, Char. Start playing like one, dude. Come on. Alright, I gotta kill the Gundam, I think. Yo, he dodged the mines? Alright, got him. Did the egg guy get him? Oh, and it's Char Zagok. Backhanded him. Backclawed him. It's some kind of psychic warfare. So here's the thing. We are a new type. The new types can communicate telepathically. One of them's playing the music in somebody's ear. Or playing it through their mind to everybody else. Because Char's a new type.
Let's just see.
Grand Theft Mobile Suit, Jaburo Stories.
That's it. There.
Smash, have you ever seen the meme? It's like somebody messing around in paint of this song, and they like put a little guy, a little picture of Char playing the trumpet. It's hilarious. I'll have to find it and share it on something. I'm out of ammo. Thank you. You were on YouTube and saw a video that said, is Bethesda taking too long for Elder Scrolls 6? I think we're not going to see that for a long time. Yeah, the video's been around for a while, Smash, of the trumpet thing. It's pretty funny, though. I mean, I think we'll get the Elder Scrolls 6 whenever it's done. And that's when I want a complete game. But I'd rather wait for it. Oh, double block. Oh, I missed though. I'm gonna die anyway. Almost stunted on them, but got didn't work out sadly.
Good.
Ooh, that was like a creepy good right there. Did you hear him? Like whispered in my ear. Didn't like that. My dear, we're still going.
Enemy invading the space fortress of Baku. Destroy the enemy mobile
suit. Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your brand new mobile suit.
I've got it. I can see the enemy.
We can see him too, Char. Why do you keep showing up, bro? Go away.
Slow.
Left.
Ow. All right, one more hit. We got him. Oh, seriously?
That's it.
Our forces are winning.
A lot of the voice lines in Zeta are sped up. Are they?
Are
it's been a long time since I've heard them, so. Oh, the gun. Wait, that wasn't enough. Wow. That is unlucky as can be. I'm a hide back here.
I told you so.
Got him.
Return.
All right, this is probably the last mission. Oh, white base is in here. Okay.
Let's just see. Let's test the reaction time of your
brand new mobile suit.
That's it.
I am happy that they've at least got the right voice actors and everything for this game. I'm pretty sure when they made it, they just ripped the audio from the
That's it.
The show itself, which is fine. Because, like, there's, like, a, was it the Elder Scroll? Or, the Elder Scroll, sorry. Dynasty Warriors Gundam 2? Pretty fun game for the most part. But, if you've ever seen G Gundam, they must not have been able to get the same voice actor for Domu and Kashu, the main pilot of the Shining and Burning Gundam. And it was so awkward hearing him talk. Like, it was a completely different voice. And, like, it just didn't seem right. So I'm happy they at least have all the right voices. I think Zeta Gundam is all correct too. Gundam versus Zeta Gundam did all the things with the voices correctly. Most of the PS2 era Gundam games do that, though. It's whenever you get to the newer stuff where the voices get kind of weird. I'm actually really curious to see if,
what is it?
G-Generation Genesis has the correct voices or not. Burning Finger? Yeah, dude. There's a Commander Zaku right there. What's it doing? Just floating across the screen? I can tell it's a Commander Zaku because you can kind of see the fin. Like there's a pixel that's changing green right there on its tip of its head. It's just floating. Where's it going? It has missile pods. Oh, there's other Zakus over there too. I'm just curious to see if anything happens here. Is that what's behind him? Is that like a line of Zaku's behind him out in the distance? I think it is. They're just floating. All the voices in Assault 2 are really cringy. I haven't played that game in a long time. Dude, I kind of want to play Battle Operation, like the original. Huh. Wait, no, those are pilots on the back of the Zakus. Oh, is this Zeon retreating from a Baoku right now? Is that what's going on here? That's kind of cool if that's what that is. Because why else would the pilots be holding onto the back of a Zaku? I don't remember this. I don't remember. I probably watched it back in the day, but it's been a while, you know. Look at that. Oh, close up. What's up, dude? Beautiful unit. Are the pilots there? Holding on. Look at that. This must be what this is them retreating from a Baoku. But that's the moon right there. I don't know where the moon is relative to a Baoku. ERP, I would wait to start playing WoW until after it fully downloads. I'm just waiting to see if anything happens right now. I don't think anything will, but you never know. Yeah, I would just wait then, RP. It's being weird. Are we done? The moon. Very nice.
On this day, Universal Century 0080, as the sounds of battle begin to fade away, the Earth Federation government and the Principality of Zeon sign a peace treaty signifying an end to this brutal war.
What is the shining part of the moon for? Is it the sun peeking through or something like that? That must be what that means, right? Huh. Okay. Who's first? Char's first. Alright, I can live with that. I mean, that's me playing Char, so. I don't know how this works. I think it depends on who you play more, and that like balances it out, which is kind of cool. I'm assuming when it was in like an arcade machine, that would be more accurate to what people were playing, but like in this scenario, it's just you. But still cool. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed our Let's Play of Mobile Suit Gundam Federation versus Zeon. It's one of my like most nostalgic games from like back in the day. It's been really fun to play again. We played through both campaigns, which is the allure to playing this. In the future, we'll probably cover Gundam versus Zeta Gundam because it's also super cool. It's the same kind of game, like similar to this game. I'll decide what we're going to play is our PS2 like kind of throwback game over the next week or so. I'm leaning towards Armored Core 3, but we'll see. I don't know. I don't know what it's going to be yet. That might be what it is. It might not be. Anyways, I'll be live tomorrow towards the middle of the day with Tales of Berseria. We're at the end of that game as well. We're gonna finish it up. We'll do some side stuff and then finish the main story. So if that interests you, make sure you stop by tomorrow. And as always, make sure you follow the channel to make sure you know when I go live. Thanks for watching tonight, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Good night.